Hi, hello, Sanbona. I'm Gabriel Mapanga, your host. Do you think you have what it takes to be a player?
Or are you a player? Dumelang, Absheni. I'm your co-host, Bongo Nonkonyana, and welcome to How to Be a Player.
Hi, I'm Franco, your Italian guest host. And sport for us is for everyone. So welcome to How to Be a Player.
Welcome to Perspective TV. You're watching How to Be a Player. I'm your host, Bongo Nonkonyana. The objective of this show is to expose different sporting bases and the different codes there is. Moreover, to get to know thriving individuals such as players, right? In this week's episode, we're focusing on football, iDisk. Now, simple basics, right? Football, which is soccer, consists out of two teams, right? Two teams, each team has a goalkeeper. Goalkeeper this side, goalkeeper that side. Now, depending on how the coach formulates the team, there's defenders, midfielders, and attackers. So do stay tuned to our show as we unpack how to be a player. Stay tuned.
Hi guys, my name is Mandla Gagai. I'm director of sport here at UWC. I love sport. And I love people that love sport. So do yourself a favor. Stay tuned on How to Be a Player. You'll see what's happening there.
Okay, no problem. How many sports codes does UWC offer?
How many?
Four.
Sport.
Sports codes.
Hockey, rugby, soccer, whatever it is.
No,
that's not a sport.
Chase, is chase one?
No. Maybe five?
Five.
Nah,
bro.
Five?
Okay.
No, actually not. Like seven.
Okay. Nah, bro.
Okay. And is there a player from UWC that recently played in the World Series?
He's got an afro. I also forgot his name.
Pitch black up.
No, he's not. He's got an afro.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Stanton Smith, head coach of UWC football, Foster Cup. A little bit about myself. I spent 10 years in the United States where I played college football and coached college football, so I have a good understanding about background about the mindset of a student athlete playing a competitive sport. I've been a professional footballer growing up myself, currently head of department school teacher in the daytime, and keen to make sure that we compete at a very high level this year in this year's Varsity Cup 2019.
Hi coach, and welcome to the show again. So we have a few questions for you, starting with, what do you think makes a student or a player a student athlete here at University of Western Cape?
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity to have a talk today. What I can say in terms of a student athlete, number one, it is quite demanding on a student athlete in terms of their commitment to a sport. Ultimately, we must remember they are first and foremost academics,
okay. at the institution. So they are students, and they have to find a way to manage their time in terms of applying themselves in both the classroom and on the sporting field. In terms of the university itself, at this level, the sport does command a lot of time, a lot of energy outside of the classroom. And in terms of that process, the athlete itself has to find the time to find the balance and to learn to prioritize their lives in terms of where they need to apply themselves.
And what are the structures in place in terms of the teams here at school and all that?
At the moment, the university has a very big and historical football program. Okay. We currently have two LFA teams, which plays in the local league. We have one in the Premier Division and one in the Super League, which is the highest local LFA division. Then we have our prestigious varsity football competition, which is the benchmark for the university. And we also compete in the USA national competition, which is held annually, which is the entrance competition into the varsity football.
Still to come, Rock and Rust.
So now that you mentioned varsity football, are there any players we should look out for? Any, yeah.
We are waiting for this. This league.
Yeah.
Varsity Cup.
Yes. At the moment, we're quite excited for this year's 2019 edition of the varsity football. As you know, we have been one of the few institutions that have competed in every major varsity football competition since its inception. Looking at this year, we are trying to build on to what we did in 2015 when we won the competition. Of course, we must all understand, in terms of varsity football, players come and go, they graduate, they're ineligible because of their age, all these factors come into play. We are quite keen to have noticed that we have brought in at least 10 first year recruits, which means the longevity of the program seems to be in a good stand. Some key players to look out for. At the moment, we have about 6 existing players from last season, all starters that are in their third year, fourth year, and they will surely be keen to make an impact in this year's competition. In terms of our new players that have come in, we've got 2 players that have now currently already been selected for the USA Under 21 National Training Camp. We've got some very good local players that have been playing in second division, first division, and we are quite excited to mix the blend and to put forth a competitive team for this year's competition.
Okay. Thank you, coach. I think you will do the best. The team will do the best at the Varsity Cup.
Yes, thank you very much.
My question is, with your experience, what can you advise? What can you advise to the new player, to the younger player?
What we thanks for the question. What we always try to instill in the players is that, number one, especially our first years, we have a fantastic mentoring program at our university and in our team. So each incoming player has like an older brother or a mentor that assists him in finding the right balance in terms of balancing their studies with their performance, with their sporting performance. So in terms of that mentoring process, there is some support on campus that will assist the student athlete, especially in their first year, in terms of finding the balance to perform both academically and through their sport.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you so much for your time, coach, and all the best this year.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much,
okay,
coach.
Thank you, coach. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Good luck
thank
with your stuff, man. I hope it works out.
Okay, and who recently won African Player of the Year? A student that came from UWC.
Oh, correct.
Okay. So today, guys, we're going to be covering the simple basics of ispati ski. How to pass, how to trap, basics, moving in space. Russ, let's start, my man. This is my boy. This is Sanji. So So today that's some pass from here to see a clear pass, Lali Dizki. Full of big awareness, you must be aware in the game, movement and all that. Are you ready? Let's go, boy. As we know, first things first, every time before a game or whatever you're doing, even if it's for fun, we warm up. Hey, Rasta! Hey, this guy. So today, oh, yes. Okay, today we're covering basics, trap and pass, as I said. But then, Sokala with the first touch of it. So, before that, what do we do, Ras?
I think we warm up.
My man, you got this. Let's go. So we're gonna start with
warm up.
warm up, bro. Keep it up. Let's go. Asambe, Ras. Okay, sure. Hey. Yes. Warm up, bro.
Full of sad days. Started at a young age, yeah. Bought a house, but I've been living on stage. Trying to find a real me, I ain't found it yet. Wake up every morning feeling like I'm guilty. Talk to God, can you hear me? Lately I'm a mess, I don't want no one to help me, yeah. I don't want no one to help me. And if you think that I make decisions based off of what you think, then you're wrong. Can't nobody think for me, I got my own thoughts. Sometimes you don't know what you had until it's all gone. Till it's all gone. If I took the hand that was dealt me, then I would be nowhere in life. Yeah, I had to think smart. Threw away the deck and got my own cards. Long before I had the money to afford a car. I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Following my dreams, yeah. I've been doing me.
Who is the current FNB UWC rugby coach?
Like,
who's
I don't know.
We don't know.
No.
Okay, you don't know. Okay. So as we said, today we're working on your first touch. It's our first. Rasta, ball. So, what are you gonna be? That's it. That's it, boy. So as I said, today, boy, we're doing your first touch. So move like a couple of meters back, and I'll throw the ball to you. I want your first touch to be on point, boy. Watch the ball and focus. Let's go. Yes, boy. So, basic number two, simple drill, you pass. That's how we. Ras! Let's go, boy. So, today is a pass, boy. I want you to pass the ball with the inside of your foot. Left, right, left, left. Let's go, right, boy. Yes, Ras, but ball is like. Drill number three is Tati Penalty. Perspective essay is in the area. So the first thing we do is Ras!
Yeah, man.
There we are. So first thing you do is you place the ball right where you saw on the spot and you take your run up. Not too long, not too short, just perfect enough that you get the ball right. And it's best that you use the inside of your foot. Pick a spot, take the penalty.
Accelerating on a double rush, I never take a break. Do it for heaven's sake. Blessings are never late. Passion is full of hate. Passion is full of hate. I cannot wait till I make it. I cannot wait till they try me and then try to take it. I gotta delay it and make sure that I never quit it. They don't need to get it. Name in the books, but it's never scripted. A 10 out of 10, I can never split it. I cover the distance, the focus, and shift it to dreams that are vivid. Ain't got no whip, but I'm driven. Watch it rotate on my pivot. I can't be too critical, even pretend I have limits. I've been on a mission, I'm seeing specifics. Bermuda, Atlantic, I'm causing a panic. They don't understand me, I guess I'm outlandish. I'm boxing through baggage, I can't touch the cabbage. Ain't nothing short of a savage, ain't nothing short of a savage. I've been too candid. Hey, I never take a break.
Hi guys, my name is Manuel Severari. I'm 23 years old. I'm a student here at UWC, currently studying BCom Information Systems, and I obviously play sports, as you can see. What about things about me? I would say that I'm a very hardworking person. I like to give 150% more than everyone else, and I like to set goals and to achieve them. I feel like, you know, you can't do things without goals, you know, and you need to strive for excellence. So yeah, that's who I am, and that's what I'm about.
Sir, you must first try to get the ticket.
I'm gonna leave you.
Okay.
Welcome back to How to Be a Player. We're still here with our guest, Emmanuel. So please reintroduce yourself, please.
Good afternoon, guys. I'm Emmanuel Severami. I'm 23 years old and I'm a UWC student. And I'm a player here for UWC.
Player. He's a player. He came to play.
Yeah.
So Manny, what do you think? What do you think you need to be a student and a player at the University of Western Cape?
So yeah, guys are just not faced with challenges on the field, but off the field as well. And it's not easy, you know, for many of us to share the problems, you know. But I feel like you need to really work hard. You need to stay humble. Like I said, set goals. It's very important. Mm. Know where you want to be.
Oh, yeah.
You know what you want in life, and you can work towards it. I mean, being a student athlete requires a lot of sacrifice. You're going to lose your friends, your social life. It requires a lot of discipline, what you eat, times you sleep, you know, all those things.
Really
in order to really be at the level, you know, if you want to be average, fair enough, you can do what other people do. It's going to give you bad results.
So you've got to work hard and everything.
Definitely. So if you want to win, for instance, Varsity Cup, you got to work hard. You got to do something others don't do, you know.
So players work hard, my man.
Definitely.
So
you
that's
know,
the first thing you remember.
I haven't seen a lazy player.
Yeah.
No lazy player, man.
You know, there's no lazy players. So yeah, it's all about working hard, you know, and having like those goals and achieving them, you know. But as well, being patient, knowing that it will come. You know, you can't rush it.
Hi guys,
my name is Tamago Gonia.
I'm Kumani Ndaba, and all the visuals are brought to you by Young Black Hungry. Work hard, bro.
And how long have you been doing this then?
How long have I been doing it?
Yes.
It's been ages, eh? I think when I was in my mother's stomach, I was
kicking
it, you know, you know, practicing it and all that. So for me, it just feels natural just to be out there and do what I love, and you know, to share it with friends as well, and engage with others as well.
So having fun,
yes,
as well.
Fun,
yeah,
you know, it's all about that. You know, if you don't enjoy what you're doing, then you're not gonna, you know, excel at it, you know. So the enjoyment factor is very important.
Okay. So one question that I always wanted to know is how, as a student athlete, do you manage your time as a student and as an athlete? Do you mix and match, or is it like something that just natural?
Well, it was not easy getting. Yeah, at UWC, obviously coming from high school, it's a different lifestyle.
So once I got here, it was all about time management, you know, making sure that everything is in order, you know. And to be honest, a lot comes with less sleep. You know, if you're going to be a student athlete, you've got to bring class. You've got to excel there as well, you know. At the end of the day, we're not just here for sports, but...
I think you were writing not long ago, and I saw you training on the day when you were writing.
He was training.
Yeah. No, I believe that you've got to work hard, and if you manage your time properly, like prior to that session this morning, I was working. I was up for, what, 10, 12 hours to make sure that I have at least an hour to be on the field.
Yeah.
You see, it's to make sure that I've covered that work so that once I'm done, I go to the paper and do my thing. So I do not like being behind, you know. I feel like, you know, I got to make sure that training is very important to me. I've got to be there.
Players, you know, always got to be ahead.
Yeah, you have to be ahead, you know. If you want to be the best, you got to, you know, set high standards. And I feel like if we can get into good habits or rub off other players or... It's not just for me, but for my teammates to see that you can manage time, you know, and you can do it. Because most students feel like, okay, they start 2 weeks, you know, time balance, and then it doesn't work out, and they go back to old ways.
Yeah.
But it's, you know, you got to keep going. You got to be disciplined, you know. And it requires a lot of things, you know, like you got to eat properly. You can't be eating 10 o'clock. You know, most of the students, you know, and all that, you know. So you, really, you just got to have a fixed time on how you do things, you know. Especially if you can get a sleep in, try and get a lot of sleep in and stuff. Yeah, but, yeah.
Yeah, so we know you are a hard worker and a good student, and you combine very well these two activities. So you, what do you suggest? What can you advise to youngster now?
So what can I suggest to youngsters out there? I feel like they should spend a lot of time with older, more experienced sportsmen.
Like yourself.
Yeah.
Like, well, thank you very much for that, Jay. You know, but yeah, you know, spend a lot of time with people that's been doing it.
With
players, so that you can pick up on those habits. The earlier you can learn to become a professional, the easier it's going to be for you. You know, you get guys wanting to be professionals, but they're only willing to work when they're professional. It doesn't work like that. You got to work when you're 16, 17, 18, even before that, and get into that habit so that when you are professional, it's easy. Because you get guys that become pros and they can't handle their lifestyle.
Yeah.
And they come back down.
Talking of which, do you still see yourself as a professional athlete in whatever sport?
You know, everyone has dreams, obviously, to be a professional in whatever sporting code that they want to be. And I feel that definitely I work hard, you know, and I know I can do it. You know, anyone can do it, you know. And at the same time, I feel like I need to have education. You know, I need to have something to fall on. You know, because sometimes things don't go your way.
Yeah, that's true.
So you gotta have those, you know, those areas covered. So, yeah, but being a professional, definitely, you gotta set these standards and you can go for it. You know, there's nothing stopping you. So yeah, we'll see what the future has for all of us.
Yeah, that's amazing.
This is a true or false question. So, is there a player from UWC that recently saved in the World 7 Series? Small guy.
I wouldn't say small. He's 1'8".
Yeah, but...
He's 1'8".
But on TV, he looks small.
And, well, I have like one more question for you.
Okay.
And this is like the most important question. This is for our viewers. So now, one question I want to ask you is what makes you a player? What makes you a player?
What makes me a player?
Yeah.
I think just the fact that I can engage and make people comfortable, I think it makes things easy for me, you know. And makes guys around me feel comfortable, my teammates, you know, they just express themselves, and that's very important.
And
having guys around, and trust, definitely. You know, once guys can express themselves, then results will come.
Yeah.
You know, just working hard, you know, being humble, doing what I need to do, you know, keeping 150%, you know, makes me a player.
Alright. So, in this house, we have a couple of challenges, right?
Yeah,
we have our challenges on our challenge board, and we have this segment called Try Another Sport. In that segment, we have about three sports, okay? We have a 50-meter swim. 50-meter swim, that is one lap from one point to the other point. So you try, you do it as fast as you can, because that's going to go on the board. You're going up the board. It's either that, or you can try for 100-meter dash. We can try to be the fastest person in the school. Do you want to try to be? Do you, you do know we have Luke in the school. So yeah, you can choose. And we also have Mo. So we have about three choices. You can kick half an angle. You can try that one as well. So you, you can pick one of those.
Yeah, it's a bit too easy.
Yeah, too easy.
Why not just do all of them?
You want to do all of them?
No, just kidding.
Play on, play on.
That's what a player does. A player do it.
What do you think would be the...
swimming.
Swimming.
Let's do that. Let's
you want to try swimming? Okay, yeah, stay tuned as Emmanuel attempts his swimming lap on the leaderboard, on the motherboard, that is. Stay tuned for the next segment.